Hi, this is Asa, and welcome to my audio experience. This show is about you. It's about your health and your life. So if you're struggling with your health, I'm here to help. If you're doing really, really well, want to do better, I'm here to help. Well, I have questions about your health. Hear your on-air personal success stories. You've applied some of these foundational health principles provided on this show, and your life and health have been empowered and transformed, then we want to hear from you. Maybe you've lost some weight, begin recovering from a certain health challenge, or simply have a better outlook on life. If you're a little better today than you were yesterday, then give us a call. We want to hear from you. Remember, when you share your story, you give people hope, and hope is some of the best medicine anyone could ever have. Let me know what's going on with your health by giving me a call, 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Let's go with Ernest. Hi, Ernest. Welcome to the show, my friend. How can I help?
Hey, thank you. Thank you, Doc, for taking my call.
Sure, Ernest.
I'm having problems with my knee.
All right.
Both of them, as a matter of fact.
Okay.
It started about 10 years ago. I run up and down some steps carrying paint, and it got me. And somebody put me on cod liver oil. And after I'd already been to a chiropractor about 12 times, but it just helped me for that little while. And then I started doing that cod liver oil, and it seemed to help me quite a bit. But now then, that's 10 years later, it's coming back. Of course, I stayed off of the cod liver oil a little bit, and I'm not taking it like I did back then.
Right.
And I've had cortisone shots in both knees, and then in my left knee I had 5 shots put in, one a week.
Five shots, okay.
I had that done twice, one last winter, and again 4 weeks ago I got my last shot in it.
Okay.
But I don't know. I'm walking on it, and all my doctors tell me to do is like you've been doing. So I thought maybe you had some magic formula. If you don't, well, give me one of them pills for the old people.
Well, you're not old. You're still young. And the key is with joint health, knee health, shoulder health, hip health, whatever we're looking at with joints, you have to eliminate inflammation from the body. One of the first things we need to do, and the cod liver oil is great. You know, that's why it was helping, but it's not everything. You have to really make some changes in your life. The things you're eating every day, Ernest, are going to make a big difference in your joint health. And one of the best things you can do, literally, is change your lifestyle habits. And so, you know, I know exercise and moving is important. It's important for all of us. And I know that's hard to do that when your knees are grinding and popping and not feeling too great. So one of the first things I would do is I'd get my book, Empowering Your Health, and I'll get started on the anti-inflammatory diet that's in there. And real simple to follow, very easy to do. And, you know, what I would do is get started with that. It's very simple. 3 meals a day, which you're probably eating now. And you'll do a simple thing of eating equal amounts of lean protein sources like chicken, fish, beef, eggs, low glycemic carbohydrates in the form of fruits and vegetables, and then good healthy fats. And the healthy fats are the omega-3s, 6s, and 9s like almonds, walnuts, cashews, avocados, and things of that nature. Let's go to Ebony. Hi, Ebony. Welcome to the show.
Hey. I was calling because I was looking forward to finding some relief from my ear pain that I've been having for almost a year and a half.
When did it start? It started a year and a half ago, but what caused it? Do you know, did it come out of nowhere, or did you have an injury?
No, actually what I believe that started causing it, I became pregnant, I want to say a year and a half ago, and like, I want to say almost 6 months throughout my pregnancy, I started having like hooting noises in my left ear. And after I started having the hooting noises in my left ear, I started to have pains as well, like, and they kept telling me when I went to the doctor, there's no ear infection, we don't see any signs of anything being wrong. But at the same time, in my pregnancy, they had diagnosed me as having protein in my urine, but they couldn't even tell me what was wrong there as well. They said it could be signs of preeclampsia, but they wasn't sure because they said I didn't have any high blood pressure or anything, and I never showed anything like that. But I know that after I had my baby, it went away. And then it came back, not only with the hooting noises, but the aching and the pain. And, like, even when I get water or any mist or any kind of thing in my ear, it won't drain out by itself. And, like, I went to an ENT. They can't tell me anything. They keep saying everything is fine, nothing is wrong. But I know something is wrong, and
Yeah, no one knows your body better than you. That's the bottom. Always remember that when you're talking with physicians. We all do the best we can, but at the end of the day, you, when it comes to symptoms, mm-hmm. you know your body better. You know, diagnostic testing is great. It can show so much, but when you say there's something that doesn't feel right, you got to stand by that. So, mm-hmm. so it feels like it feels like it won't drain, right?
It feels like it won't drain, and then it makes the hooting noises, and then it even has, like, the pain. You know how, I guess it's kind of like an earache, but it's not an earache to a certain extent. I don't know how to explain that.
No, it's okay. I get it. Only on one side?
It can travel from both sides. It go from side to side. I know that's weird,
that's not weird. It's not weird at all. Let me explain a couple of things to you. The body, the way that it functions, you've got three sides to it. You got the mental side, and the chemical side, and the structural side.
Okay.
And this is why all three sides of the health triangle are really important. The mental side, brain chemistry, neurotransmitters, subconscious mind. Then you've got the chemical side. That's your body chemistry, how your heart, liver, lungs, kidneys, how all of those kind of systems work. And then you got the structural side. That's the bones, the muscles, and the nerves, and how well they function in the body as well. Well, the reason that's important is because when you're dealing with anything within the ear and you've done everything you can, whether it's antibiotics or whatever, you've ruled out the potential of a bacterial infection or any type of viral infection, fungal infection, whatever, then you've got to look at the structural side, because at the base of the neck, the first bone in the neck is called the atlas or C1. And there's nerves that come out of there and it goes into those areas. There's a couple of nerves that actually go in and connect with the ear canal. And if there's something that's not right in the base of the neck, sometimes working in that area, you can go to a DO, which is an osteopathic physician. And by working in that area, it actually, and moving around, there's some instrumentation that can be used to move that area around just a little bit. They'll do some x-rays and they'll check it and see exactly what's going on in that area. And they can figure out if there's a neurological component to it. And sometimes there can be, or even muscular component that can be pulling that bone out of place, causing irritation to the nervous system in that area. And that can be causing what you're feeling. Very, very, I've seen that several times clinically. So I would actually go to a DO, that's an osteopathic physician, and ask them to take a look at that. Usually they can go in and do some x-rays and some testing and figure out what's going on. But that's the move that I would make and see what kind of results. So go see a DO. That's the kind of doctor you want to see. And get back to me. 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. I'm your health and lifestyle coach. You're listening. The show is Diagnosing Hope, one caller at a time. 80% of the health challenges we face today are diet and lifestyle related. If you can lifestyle your way into getting sick, I've got good news for you. You can lifestyle your way out and get well.
Are you looking for increased strength, endurance, and recovery? Well, look no further than an all-natural nutritional supplement called Concrete Creatine Hydrochloride. Creatine Hydrochloride is the most absorbable form of creatine on the market today. Concrete Creatine Hydrochloride only takes a small dose to make a major impact in our health. Creatine has now come on the scene as just more than for strength athletes. Creatine has so many health benefits from around the spectrum, but Concrete Creatine Hydrochloride is the absolute best. I use it every single day. I've been using creatine since my days as strength and conditioning coach at Florida State University, and I can tell you that Concrete Creatine Hydrochloride is the best absorbable form of creatine on the market today. It will increase your strength, improve recovery, and just help the body function at its peak level. Make sure to check out Concrete Creatine Hydrochloride at most retailers, especially Walmart, or you can check them out at walmart.com.
To find out more, connect with OnCall Radio online at InShapeNetwork.com.
That's 888-283-7272. I'm Health and Lifestyle Coach. You're listening to the show that's empowering your health. Thanks for joining me on the program. If you need a new prescription for your life, then make an appointment with me right now. 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Kick the segment off and go with Doyle. Hi, Doyle. Welcome to the show. How can I help?
Thank you for taking my call. I was called on behalf of my sister, and okay. She is just turned 56, and she was diagnosed with colon cancer back about a couple of months ago, and they tried to take it out, and it was attached to her pelvis, and it stays four, and it spread to her liver, and she's also a diabetic too, and I was just trying to find her a way. Some food, some antioxidants to eat, like a juice or something that wouldn't go against her diabetes. And I bought this book at the bookstore, Eating Well Through Cancer. And I can't think of the name of the author, but I thought maybe that you could give me some kind of a regime or something like it that would help her fight off this. She's had two chemos. So in the last 2 weeks, she's had, and they're trying to shrink it where they can go back in and take the cancer out where they can get it. It's attached to her pelvis, and I'm just trying to see if I could, not go against her diabetes, not help one and go against the other.
Well, I think that let me tell you this. What I'm going to tell you as far as her lifestyle choices and things that she should do, whether it's cancer or diabetes, is all one and the same, meaning that you want to do the same protocol, similar anyway, to her lifestyle choices, the things that she's eating every single day, the water that she's drinking, the things that she's doing to make her health better is going to be the same whether you're dealing with diabetes or cancer. So one is going to help the other. Does that make sense? So the things I'm going to tell you, it's not going to go against anything that she currently is dealing with or she has a challenge with, but it's only going to help everything. So you have to look at cancer for what it is. Cancer is abnormal cells. You've got good cells and you've got bad cells. Cancer, bad cells. And so every single day the body is regenerating. And that means that every day old cells are dying off, new cells are forming. And so understanding that just at a real common sense level, the things that we're doing every single day to our bodies, we're either enabling our bodies to make good new healthy cells or we're enabling our bodies to make bad cells. And based on the things that we put inside of our bodies every single day, whether it's the food that we eat, the water we drink, the stress that we go through, the rest that we get or don't get, is going to determine how well our bodies are going to function. So that's where she is. And remember, for her, and really for anybody for that matter, food is the greatest drug we have. And so changing her lifestyle choices, regardless of the fact that she's in stage four with cancer, is going to give everybody peace of mind. It's going to give her peace of mind because she's doing everything she can every single day to make her body better. And when you're fighting against something like cancer, which is difficult enough, she needs to make sure that she's doing everything she can. And it gives you peace of mind too, because as you're walking through this with her, that she's fighting and she's doing everything she can. So let's talk about that. In my book, Empowering Your Health, there's a diet plan and there's a way of eating, I like to call it, and it's called the anti-inflammatory diet, reducing inflammation in the digestive tract. That's the first thing you want to do, whether you're dealing with arthritis, fibromyalgia, heart disease, cancer, diabetes, whatever it might be. Because when you reduce the amount of inflammation in the body, especially in the digestive tract, then you're allowing the body to function better. You're allowing it to perform better. You're allowing it to get rid of the inflammation that's causing the body not to regenerate good, new, healthy cells. That's the first thing you want to do. Real simple to follow, too. It's not a lot of difficult things for her to eat and to choose from. These are things that are going to be very easy for her. So the things that she can eat are, she'll want to stay away from grains, cow's milk, dairy. So I would stay away from wheat products. Now, I know right now she's probably eating some of those. So, breads, pastas, cereals, crackers, those sorts of things, they can stimulate too much inflammation in the digestive tract for where she is right now. So I would come off of those for at least 8 weeks, but there's plenty of foods that she can eat, plenty of lean quality protein sources like chicken, fish, beef, eggs, the carbohydrate sources she'll want to choose from, low glycemic in the form of fruits and vegetables, which will give her those antioxidants that you're talking about and give her other things that she needs, essential vitamins and minerals and anti-cancer properties. Things like broccoli have huge amounts of anti-cancer properties in them, in the foods alone. Her healthy fats, the omega-3s, 6s, and 9s, like the almonds and walnuts and cashews, these things, avocados, cod liver oil, all of those highly anti-cancer, but they're also beneficial in building up the body. So it's about getting a good foundation.
Yes. Well, I was out, I was going to get her a juicer and just, put like asparagus, carrots, stuff like that, but I didn't know if it had any sugar in that it would go against her diabetes.
No, it would not do that. And I'll tell you, that's not a bad idea. The Juice Man juicer is fine. Is she handle food right now? Is it okay for her to eat, or has she lost her appetite yet?
Well, she's taking some kind of chemo it's a new chemo that's come out, a new medicine that the day of her chemo, she has to eat everything or drink at room temperature. She wears gloves. She can't put her hands in the refrigerator or nothing, or
right.
It's like frostbite.
Okay.
And she has to drink everything room temperature. And she don't have much of a, like the first few days, she comes home with a pump. That lasts a couple of days. She
sure.
stays up for 5 hours. They send her home with a pump, goes back a couple of days, takes it off.
Okay.
And about a few days, she eats a little bit, like drinks water and eats a few vegetables, stuff like that. But she don't have much appetite during that time.
All right. What I would do is I would do the juicer, and I would do fruits and vegetables. I would follow the principles of the anti-inflammatory diet that's in my book, and also get as much food in her as possible. You can do protein-type shakes. You want to use a whey protein that is antibiotic-free, hormone-free. But you want to make sure that she's getting high-quality nutrients. Broccoli seed extract, these two are very good for her. Broccoli seed extract, you can get these at a health food store. And then also adenosyl cycobalamin, a version of B12. Adenosyl cycobalamin. Just remember the A version of B12. Both of those will help her walk through this process. Talk to your oncologist and see if she can keep high levels of vitamin C as well. Thanks for the call, my friend. Questions about your health? 888-283-7272.
Are you ready to chow? It's time for Keto Chow. When it comes to eating healthy, the keto diet has become one of the nutrition leaders in optimizing health, losing unwanted weight, and reaching your health and wellness goals. No extravagant cooking, no long kitchen cleanup, and most importantly, especially for me, it's convenient. Just put quality keto chow powder in a bottle, add some heavy whipping cream or your favorite fat, a little water, and boom, shake it up, and you're ready to chow. Keto chow tastes amazing. So make keto chow easy for you and your family today with keto chow. Let's go chow. Visit keto chow online at ketochow.xyz. That's ketochow.xyz.
To find out more, visit the show online, InShapeNetwork.com.
This is the show where your health is your greatest wealth. I'm your health and lifestyle coach. This is Healthy Talk Radio. Thanks for joining me on the program. If you'd like to participate in the show, you can jump in and call 888-283-7272. Check in, get on the phone, and let's get well. 888-283-7272. It's time to stop worrying, folks, and start living. Let's get healthy together, just you and me. Your answers are just a phone call away. 80% of the health challenges we face today are diet and lifestyle related. That means if you can lifestyle your way into getting sick, you can lifestyle your way out and get well. Give us a call now, 888-283-7272. Powering your health, empowering your life. That's what this show is all about. We'll kick this segment off and go with Brian. Hi, Brian. Welcome to the show, my friend. How can I help?
The reason I'm calling is I have a daughter who's going to turn 10 in 2 weeks, but even from, I think, about 2, her mother and I recognized signs in her that led us to think that she may be suffering from depression or even at that age, she would brood and be sullen, and it's carried on throughout her life. When our second daughter was born, when she turned 4, I guess it kind of came to a head, and at our pediatrician's advice, we took her to see a child psychologist to coach us through a couple of months of therapy, and since that time, we've returned to see him again. And we you know, learned some exercises and drills and things like that to kind of help modify her behavior. But I think there's a root problem that all of this coaching isn't helping. And I was wondering, are there dietary plans or something like that that might be of any use to us?
What is the so what is the pediatrician, what's their final say right now when you've gone to talk with them? What do they say?
Well, I don't know that there's actually a formal diagnosis right now. We've been in contact with our pediatrician again about maybe having blood work drawn and to have some testing done, but they said that, you know, it's brain chemicals and blood work won't reveal anything. And so we've contacted the same child psychologist again about a battery of tests he suggested that would determine whether it was a clinical problem or if it were, you know, just a mental state, I guess, or something. We haven't done those yet. They're in the mail, and we've, you know, we're just going to be waiting to find out what happens. But right now, to my daughter's credit, I think even she recognizes that she has problems because she'll sometimes take herself to her school counselor and talk to her about, you know, just morass she seems to be in all the time and just feeling sad and lonely and depressed. It, I think it goes beyond being just, you know, a normal 10-year-old girl. I think there's something more to it.
Well, it definitely, if you're looking at depression and that's what you're seeing in her, you know, I would definitely want to talk with your pediatrician and let them see about formally diagnosing it. But I mean, as a parent, you know your child. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's no one knows your child better than you, and you can see it, and you see the changes in her. And so that's the real challenging thing with all of it is watching her go through that. There are a lot of things you can do with depression or depressive type issues. You want to make sure that her body's functioning well and that you're giving her the right things every single day. Because if not, it's very easy for the neurotransmitters, which are the brain chemicals inside of her brain, such as serotonin, which is the big one with depression, to get off or off kilter. Okay, meaning it can be decreased in function. It can be not enough serotonin. There can be too much serotonin. There can be different things that can throw her into depression. There can also be the lifestyle things or the typical life stressors that could be doing it as well. I mean, at 10, you would think that any child would be happy-go-lucky. But, you know, that's not the case a lot of times. Is there anything around her, you know, there in the family life that you could think that might have thrown her into this or might be a challenge for her?
No. Her depression sometimes is, you know, causes a lot of angst, I guess, just because she's kind of rigid in her belief systems, and I don't mean like in a faith way, but if she gets something in her head, she's real slow to yield any other way of thinking, which, you know, can throw my wife and I into fits. But we're normal parents. I mean, we make just as many mistakes as anybody, but we're not overbearing.
Right.
You know, we're encouraging and nurturing, I think, and we love both of our children very much. But again, I mean, we started seeing this at such a young age, and it's just breaks our heart sometimes to just listen to her or, you know, just see the strain or the pain in her face. I guess from, you know, a dietetic standpoint, one of the things the child psychologist first looked at was what she was eating, because at the time she was constipated, and he said that, believe it or not, that would might be contributing a lot to her her attitude and the problems she's having. But she's since grown out of that, so it's not there anymore. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
I was just going to say, I would, and I don't mean to cut you off, but I would go this route, just listening to you and where she is. You know, knowing that her personality type tends to be very strong-willed and opinionated, that's, you know, not a bad thing. It just is what it is. And those can be – those qualities can be very good, as you know. They can be used in
right.
great ways as she grows older. But I would look right now at getting some sound lifestyle choices made for her by the things that mm-hmm. she's eating every day. Very simple. Because if you get that foundation laid, you can build anything on top of that. And at 10 – you know, a lot of times kids, they know what they like, and you put things in front of them, and they, you know, if she's opinionated, she's probably going to like certain foods and be very strong against things she doesn't like. If she doesn't like broccoli, you know, that mouth is going to stay shut. She's probably not going to eat it. But but there's things you can do to get her to eat the right things. Because, like, in my book, Empowering Your Health, I lay out in a complete eating plan called the anti-inflammatory diet. I think it would be very good for her because it's going to give her all the nutrients that she needs, the proteins, the fats, and the carbohydrates. Nothing will be weighed heavy on one side or the other, but she'll get a little bit of everything that she needs. And that's going to be important for her growth and development. Proteins for her cell growth and the fats for her skin, hair, and nails, and also her hormone development. And then the carbohydrates for her energy reserves, antioxidants, vitamins, and minerals. So she's going to get everything that she needs based on the things she's eating. I would increase some supplementation, though, and I would talk to your pediatrician about it. But I'm a big fan of cod liver oil for kids because the omega-3 fats that are in there, really important for her brain function and development. Also mental focus as far as, you know, staying very focused. And it can keep a child out of depression, something simple as fish oil, which cod liver oil is the best. And I would do a teaspoon a day. You could even do, I would go up to a couple of teaspoons a day. She could probably handle that for a month or two, and then you can back it back down. But she should be fine with that. I would check her vitamin D levels, because even in a child, that's important to make sure those levels are up, and it can throw a person, whether a child or an adult, into more of a depressed state on a regular basis. Now, when she's eating the foods in the anti-inflammatory diet, I would make sure she's taking the foundational four supplements as well, because you're at a place where you want to take some little baby steps, if you will, some little daily steps to get her where she needs to be so her body can function much better than it is right now. And getting her brain chemistry leveled out, that's going to be, you'll notice it. You'll notice the things that I'm mentioning to you, which are just basic, basic foundational things, you'll notice a change in her in about a week. If you don't, then we need to go a different route. But at any rate, I wouldn't change any of the things I told you. That's just going to be our foundation. We can build on top of that. But again, blood work would be good. If you're considering that route, I think you should go that route with her pediatrician just to check some of the basic values, see where she is. And it just gives us some great tools of information to see where we need to go from there. All right, questions about your health, give us a call, 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. If you need a new prescription for your life and you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, let's go to Mike. Hi, Mike. Welcome to the show, my friend. How can I help?
Yes, I'm having a lot of knee pain on both my knees. I have had surgeries in both of them. For torn cartilage, just working hard, playing harder. And right. But I was also diagnosed with a bulging or herniated disc in my C6, C7 area.
Okay.
And that, just the combination of those two issues have just, you know, kind of makes almost life unbearable.
So what are your plans right now? Your physician suggested anything? Are you just dealing with the pain?
As far as the neck, he has given me three options, which are medication that he basically prescribes patients with seizures to basically stop the signal from that nerve that that's in that area. The second option is injections, and the third option is surgery.
Okay.
And I was like, no.
None of those sound good. Yeah, and they don't. I agree. Those are, just so you know, those are standard treatments that are available. So he's not saying anything that's crazy or out of the ordinary. Those are pretty standard. But there's some other things I think that we need to get into, because, Mike, you know, the neck issues that you have, the bulging disc and issues with your knees, those are things that can all be corrected with proper application, proper therapy, and proper treatment. But it's just going the right direction and making the right changes. We're going to talk about the health triangle that I always discuss in natural medicine that looks at the entire body. We're not just looking at the nerves, and we're not just looking at the disc and the neck. We need to look at the entire body and see how the body is affecting your overall process, so that surgery really wouldn't be the best option. We just need to have some surgery on your lifestyle choices and rearrange some things in Mike's life, and I think that's going to make a huge difference. We'll talk about that when we come out of this commercial break.
Hi, it's Asa. I'm giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to AsaRx.com and get your free book today.
Connect with OnCall Radio and watch OnCall TV at InShapeNetwork.com.
That's 888-283-7272. I'm your health and lifestyle coach. You're listening to the show that's empowering your health. Thanks for joining me on the program. If you need a new prescription for your life, then make an appointment with me right now. 888-283-7272 or send me an email. Going into the break, I was talking with Mike. Mike's been dealing with several issues. He's had bulging disc in his neck and also issues with his knees. And Mike, I was telling you that although, you know, the pain and they've given you three options of, you know, medication that's basically a seizure medication to help block the nerve impulse and also the injections and surgery, and you don't want to go any of those routes. I don't blame you. I wouldn't either. But you have to look at your body and the reason it's breaking down. You have to look at all three areas of the health triangle that we use in natural medicine. And if you look at all three sides, you got the mental side, the chemical side, and the structural side. And the mental side, your brain chemistry, your subconscious mind, neurotransmitters, and that sort of thing. The chemical side is how your body takes the food that you eat every single day, breaks them down, turns it into either good cells or bad cells. So it's how your physiology works, how your heart, liver, lungs, kidneys, how well they function, as well as nutritional deficiencies that might be there. So you have to look at all of that. And then also the structural side, the bones, muscles, and nerves, which, of course, you're experiencing right now. But see, one of those and all of those affect each other. So the bulging disc, I don't know. I mean, I think there's a better option. I think that you have to look at the structural part of the body and say, okay, why did these discs create a bulge in them? Why are they out of alignment? And why are they not functioning the way they need to? One of the best rehab and the best ways to correct any structural component in the body, especially when you're dealing with the spine, is either osteopathic medicine or chiropractic medicine. And so that would be a DO. The doctor would be a DO or a DC. Both of those would be very helpful, I think, in your situation. And I would encourage you to get a consultation or go meet with somebody in that field, because I think they'd be able to help you quite a bit. There's spinal decompression therapy. They can actually do that. A lot of that is for the lower back. They also do that on the neck. And what it'll do, it can help retract that little bulging disc area. So that's another thing that can help quite a bit. And then also I would consider changing the way that you're eating, because when you're dealing with a bulging disc, you're dealing with knee pain and that sort of thing. There's inflammation involved with that. So anytime there's inflammation involved with anything in your body, you need to reduce it as much as possible throughout the body. And the way you'll want to do that is by the things that you're eating. Remember, you reduce inflammation in the digestive tract, makes a huge difference all throughout the body. So the anti-inflammatory diet that's in my book, Empowering Your Health, is where I would start. Very simple to follow, easy to follow, and, you know, it's not twigs and berries. There's plenty of foods you can eat and enjoy, and that's where I'd get started. It really would, and that's one of the great places you can start. And with this, I wouldn't do anything until I've had an osteopathic physician, which is a DO or a DC, a chiropractic physician, look at it and evaluate it, do the tests that they would do some of the treatments that they would do, and see how you come out, because there's 101 ways to take care of that, and I'm sure those physicians will be able to give you great care and put you on a path, I think, that would really surprise you. So that's the route I would go first. I would do that. Physical therapy can be good as well, but I would see those physicians first and then go into a physical therapy mode possibly after. Laser therapy can be good as well. I've seen a lot of great results with that clinically. Laser therapy is now FDA approved, and it can help regenerate cells. It can help repair tissues that are torn or damaged. It's just amazing. So that is something that I would look into as you're going through this process. Okay, so that's something to get started with. But the anti-inflammatory diet, get started with that. B vitamins are going to be important. You're dealing with nerve-related issues, any kind of nerve pain, vitamin B5, vitamin B6. And the B6 you want to do in the version of pyridoxal 5-phosphate. They have B6 in the version of pyridoxine, pyridoxal chloride, and then pyridoxal 5-phosphate is the better version of that. It's a lot easier on your body. Your body will absorb it, utilize it much better, and you'll get a better result. So that's just something to lay in there. Cod liver oil, of course, I would do a tablespoon probably twice a day as you're working on this. But when you're going through therapy, if you go see one of those physicians that I laid out for you, I think you're going to see a big change. But nothing's going to change unless you make some lifestyle changes. So the things that you're eating has to happen. It really does. And I don't want to see you have to go down that surgery route. It's very painful, and the rehab from that can be a real challenge. So I would do everything I can. I would, you know, I know you've rejected all three of those, and you're really looking for an answer. I would do everything I could until at the end of the day, and this is what I tell any patient, that you're sitting there and you literally can't function in life unless you have surgery. So until you're at that point, which you're not at all, until you're at that point, I wouldn't even consider it. And I would go every other route you can. Acupuncture has some great results as well. But I think with the place you are, going with the DO or DC right now is a great first point. And then, you know, we can move into something else later. But I'm here for you each and every night. So go that route, get a consultation, see what they come up with. You can always email me or we can talk about it more here on the show. Okay? Thanks for the call, my friend. Questions about your health, give us a call, 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Jonathan from Topeka, Kansas writes, I've recently been struggling with low energy levels. I don't really know what to do. I'm tired in the morning, but it gets better throughout the day. Jonathan, that's adrenal fatigue, classic symptoms. Vitamin C and vitamin B5 will bring that up. Stay off the coffee, switch to green tea, and make sure you stay off sugar and all of those related products. Any type of processed food is going to cause you to have issues with adrenal fatigue. Thanks so much for the email. Puts another hour in the charts. This is the show that's empowering your health. If you're calling the show, we missed you. Don't forget, you can always email me. Forget about the past. It's gone. Focus on today. That's your gift, and realize your best days are still ahead. Empowering your health, empowering your life. That's what this show is all about.
You could listen to the AsaRx audio experience on Spotify and Pandora. For all the ways to watch and listen, check out our show page at asarx.com/experience.
Hi, it's Asa. I'm giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to asarx.com and get your free book today.
This episode is over. But check episode notes for links to products and services you've heard about on this episode. Thanks for listening and subscribing. Please share the AsaRx audio experience with others and stay in touch by giving us your comment or review.